What's up, guys? It's Isaiah from Games, and this will be episode 14 of our Gaimoria Dev stream. Might sound a little hoarse right now. I just woke up from a nap. I'm busy, and so I have to sneak in a nap when I can. On Wednesday, I was working on the Ember enemies. I already kind of started prepping this for our next group of enemies that I'm going to be sketching. And I'm going to be doing the Grasslands and Autumn's Lands. There's 5 enemies total, 4 pawns and a knight. And I decided to do this one because since there's only 5, I'm aiming for this for my sketching portion to get done faster. Whereas like this, there's 6. And that there were several knights and all that. So the fact that this is just 4 pawns and a knight, I am hoping that I can get the sketching done faster, and then I can do more coloring. So that's the goal. You can see I have continued to group up the enemies that I've been making, just so that when I work on stuff, I can continue to check their design consistency to make sure that they kind of fit with the other stuff. Oh yeah, I need to post on social media that I'm doing things. I already made the file, I just need to post it. And, as usual, let me know if the music is too loud. Business. So, I'm gonna open up my ref board just like I have with all the others, start throwing my references in there for this zone, and then get to sketching. So I definitely want to have a mushroom enemy in here because that's kind of like, just reminds me a lot of Secret of Mana, because there's mushrooms, like rabbits and mushrooms are the first things you encounter. You guys are kind of cool. Maybe be a knight. And since this is the earlier zone, most of the enemies here are going to be cute. One thing I had mentioned is the other zones, they look a little more fearsome, but in this zone they're going to kind of be just cute little funny things. I kind of already have a couple. So I'm actually going to bring them in. And do that before I forget. I'm gonna redraw him. This little bird dude. Because this is kind of a really old sketch. This guy too, so put him in here. This actually makes it so I'll have even more time to do coloring. So I've actually already built a full idle animation for this bee too, which is good because that means I'm further ahead with that enemy. So this guy's like done already, and you can see already fits in nicely with the other designs and stuff too. But this guy is really sketchy, so I'm gonna clean him up. One more. So this was like the very first thing I ever animated for Gaimoria. So my folder structure in here is kind of weird. You can tell his design doesn't fit as well as the other stuff. He's got like a lot more gradient painting and stuff, but I'm not gonna go through and like change his animation right now. But I'm just putting him in here just cause. You can see I have the animations and stuff already. And I didn't even have like a classic sprite sheet made for him. I did it way different. My selective color stuff's all off. You can see the there's a drastic color change here. So that's something I'll get to doing when I get through and start actually animating all these enemies down the line, but since it's pretty much the only enemy that was like this, yeah, I'm not terribly worried. So I think the wasp is going to be the pawn for the Autumn Lands, because he also kind of fits the theme of, at least when I think of Autumn, I think of wasps and hornets and all that kind of stuff. And then, let's see, this guy is definitely a grasslands enemy. This bird could be a grasslands enemy. I'm gonna go back to throwing my references in. Insects. We have two insects, a bird, some kind of quadruped, which could be this cute little pig dog thing, or it could be like a little hedgehog. I have much fewer rests for this area because kind of just, especially since I had already done work, this was like the first set of enemies I started making. I didn't need to take as many reference pictures because I already had it started. So really, I feel like this is probably all I'm going to really use. Because, let's see, so that's 1, 2, 3. So that's 3 out of 4 already, and I need a knight. So basically just need, you know, I could do just 1 or 2 more pawns, and then a knight, and then I could color those. So I'll just close it and start working, I guess. This is just gonna be like a big round bird. Basically just redrawing this guy, making him a little cleaner and simplifying his sketchiness. You can see his wings and everything is super sketchy, but I have cleaner work here, so all I'm doing is redrawing him. I cherish. They're currently my only viewer. That's how Fridays usually go, though. People are usually gone on Fridays. Right now I'm just kind of warping this guy's face to be a little more round. Looking a little flat. And his face. Yep, he'd be your best friend. If you guys can hear any other like ambient noise getting picked up from my mic, let me know too, because I tweaked my noise gate settings again, being in a different room, so I just want to make sure everything is sounding correct. So that's the updated version of that guy. Alright, I'm gonna draw a mushroom. Actually, I should grab the mushroom from Secret of Mana and put them side by side. So that's the mushroom from Secret of Mana. Mushroom from Ragnarok. Kinda like that the Ragnarok one has some pokey stuff on it, so I'm gonna make mine have some pokey stuff. Especially since I might run out of my enemy budget here. With, only having a certain number of things, so... like a pokey mushroom. You can see with my other shapes here, I like pokey stuff. They need to be a little bigger. Around the base like a crown. That's cute. I have his tongue stick out. Draw that shape. Pretty good. Still not really sold on these spike things. Might be overcomplicating it. Big ol' circles. Mario style. Trying to not have too many rough edges on this guy and most of these, because I mean they have some pointy shapes, but trying to be a little more curvy with this stuff, because more curvier shapes the less threatening they are, and these guys are in the newbie zone, so threatening is better. Looks like he's wearing a condom on his head. It's actually kind of funny, so I'm gonna keep it like that. Kind of looked like he was falling backwards. Weak. Gives him more balance. The sky will be fun to animate. You can see with the reference here, this is how they animated them. Like, in order for them to walk, they had to lift their foot really high. Kind of like waddled, and I think that's really cool. Gives a lot of character and something through its animation. Alright, I'm gonna draw this little pig dog because it's pretty cute too. And there's nothing wrong with having like one extra pawn just in case. Let's name this guy. I think the secret mana one is called Mushboom. Yes. Oh, Boomstream. Tiny eyes, huge nose, mouth and tongue, ears. Any eyes, big nose. Thank you. Big ol' fat body. Yeah, he's cute. The nice thing about grasslands too is a lot of these enemies aren't going to be aggressive, so you don't have to hurt them because they won't hurt you. Because there's no XP in this game, you're never obligated to hurt a cute little creature like this. Let's give this guy a name. He's like a pit bull meets a pig. Pig bull. A little smaller. Look how cute that is. Alright, so that's enough pawns. And knight. So I want to make this kind of little wolf thing, but maybe I could make it a raccoon. That'd be cool. So instead of copying this directly, it'd be kind of a raccoon guy. He probably wouldn't use an axe. He'd use something else. What do raccoons like? Pretty smart. A little harness. This guy's gonna be a little bigger. He's a knight. I animate them frame by frame, so I can show you a sprite sheet. Thank you. I just kind of lay them out. Show you how I animate the main character. So this is a sprite sheet for the main character of her summoning things. So I basically just draw it frame by frame. And the good thing about what I'm doing here is I'm essentially creating the first frame for all of these creatures' animations, so they will look exactly like this in-game. Yep, but it also looks a million times better than puppet animation, because I think puppet animation usually looks really ugly, and it's very noticeable. So I like doing frame-by-frame animation, and I'm getting to the point to where I can do a full animation from sketch to full colors in about 2 hours for one animation, so this whole thing maybe took 2-3 hours. So, yeah, I mean, it's plenty of work to do, but that's what it's like having a job, so you just do the work. And I'll show you what that animation looks like for a frame of reference, too. have it up on our... I have a GIF of it, actually. So this is her animation from these frames. Well, yeah, frame by frame, that's how I animate it. That's kind of the plan with these guys. I already have animations for some of these too, like the wasp. I have animations. I have animations for all these guys. These guys are all animating. Let's see here, he's animating. So yeah, I already have tons of animations. Wasp. Yeah, so last enemy here. Your link was deleted and I don't know how to fix that, because that would be awesome to be able to like make avatars from the creatures you're saying. That'd be pretty cool. And I also don't know how to undelete that stuff. Thank you for following us. Show it. Does not show it. Let's see if I can tweak my settings real fast to allow people to post links. I think I fixed it, so now I'll try relink it. I have no idea what this stuff is. I'm still pretty new to streaming. I just started like a month ago. Isaacaz. Oh, so yeah, I want to say hi to Clone Zet and Zikaz. I have never seen either of you here. So thank you for coming and hanging out. And thank you, Clone Zet, for Klonza for following. Yeah, I clicked on it. I wasn't really sure what that was. I could tell, like, you're typing stuff in to give the top hat to the little character. But I wasn't really sure, like, what that stuff was. So what do you mean they're on his stream? Like, is the little characters are just walking around while he streams? Oh, that's cool. How did he get that set up? Using Unity. It's actually been pretty awesome to work with so far. That's kind of what I was figuring. I haven't actually seen that on anyone's stream yet. Is that, like, how recent is that? Beers. Thank you for following the gods. Because. The song that's playing right now is actually also music that will be in the game. My brother's doing the music, and this is one of his songs he made. Guy's got kind of a grumpy look too. Well, that sucks. Is it too loud? Like, in relation to my voice, if it's too loud, let me know and I can decrease it. Like, if it's too hard to hear me over the music. There we go. So here's a set of some more chill enemies. These enemies are for, you know, tougher areas. But these are some cuter dudes for earlier parts in the game. So I even did one extra pawn too, just in case. I'm gonna get right in and start coloring them. That's kind of why I wanted to do the grasslands and autumn lands today, to make sure I had time to color them. Yep, pig dog. Isn't he cute? I called him a pig bull, like a pit bull, but with a pig. There, so that could be a knight for the area. He's a little bigger. Kind of like a badger, bear, raccoon thing. Call him Bad Coon. He's not very happy with it. So, that's it for all those drawings. I'm just going to start coloring right away. Someone's barbecuing. Like a bib, went cool. Thank you. Print out some wild colors on them. Yes, that's pretty accurate though. These are the ones in the grasslands and the autumn's lands, so they don't really have a specific kind of element tied to them. And you'll also see them scattered throughout the other zones. So yes, you're correct. I even have one of their folders labeled as neutral. Before I had named it grass and autumn's lands, it was just called neutral. Scheme here, red and black and light tan. You're just lagged. And if you guys follow us on any social media, you should start seeing tons of posts coming up for the next 2 months. And hopefully continuing onward. I scheduled a bunch of stuff on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook. So you'll also see lots of... It's basically all the stuff you see during the stream right now, but people that don't watch the stream, I want them to see what we're doing. Twitter and Facebook and Instagram will have more art posts. Instagram's already been pretty good. I already had a lot of that stuff scheduled, but you'll also see it on Twitter and Facebook too. Let's see how he looks. Everything is /Gaimoria. Twitter /Gaimoria, Facebook /Gaimoria, Instagram /Gaimoria. think Miss DJM is actually following us on there. Here we go. Like that color. Might desaturate his fur a little bit. Gradient, because that's what you do. The white on his head's a little too bright, so I'm gonna drop that down a tad. On to Chirpy. Gonna get a little glass of that awful whiskey real quick. Music's actually from Ragnarok, so it's funny I have all these little Ragnarok creatures and I'm listening to Ragnarok music. Really, I thought Ragnarok the game design was awful, it's so grindy, but it was just like the art and the music just kind of all came together really well and gave me lots of good memories of having fun with friends way back in junior high. Kind of like Spyro, huh? Spyro... Or is it the music you're saying? Yeah, Pokemon is a huge influence for this game. Not so much gameplay, but just creature design. Yeah, kind of like Pidgey meets Spearow. Isn't that the, like, psychic one? Standing tall, it's green, it has an eyeball on its... Oh, yeah. So it evolves into Zatu. That's what I'm thinking. Yeah, it's a lot like Natu. I wish Pokemon had... I don't know if you ever played Bravely Default or Bravely Second. I only played the demos of those games, but they basically solved the one problem I hate with turn-based games, and that's just... the gameplay gets so slow when you have to fight so many random encounters. And if Pokemon ever put in the ability to just do that fast-forward kind of thing through the battles, I would... like Pokemon so much more. Well, if you probably look up any video and you'll see what I'm talking about, but the fact that they essentially let you can turn off encounters entirely too and just skip it. Which is nice. You can't skip boss fights, but if you just want to go through a dungeon and collect the chests and all that, you can turn off all encounters and just roam the dungeon and collect all the stuff, and it's brilliant. Pokemon had something like that, I would get back into it, but the last one I played was X, which, you know, came out in like 2013, I think, and I just have no desire to play the new one coming out. Might, but it's just... I hate the turn-based stuff. The classic one on Super? See, I haven't played much Earthbound, so... Kind of make him a Tweety Bird. Kind of yellowy green. It's kind of neat. Sweet color, though. I'm usually the one who asks that, so thank you for asking me. It's nice to have viewers that are engaging. We usually have a couple people here talking, but it's kind of quiet today. I'm doing pretty good. My brother's coming in tomorrow, so we're gonna... We live in Hawaii, so he's flying in. That'll be fun, hang out with him for, I think, a week. And, yeah, doing good. Playing lots of Overwatch. Overwatch is freaking awesome. I have like 20 people on my friends list online all the time with it. That's super fun. How are you doing? What are you doing? Friday. Friday's good. Bird should have red spots. I'm gonna have red spots on the mushroom though, probably. The red stripe though down its back. You have a clever naming, as I do. I like this cream color, though. This is, I know it without even looking. It is Gerudo or Gerudo Valley, however you say it, from Zelda Ocarina of Time on Nintendo 64. When you're out in the desert riding the horse, Epona, learning how to shoot your bow and arrow, the hometown of Ganon. Sand Temple is out there, Desert Temple, where you use your, find your reflection shield and use the light to open the way to the new rooms. Saturate it a little more. At least sell the Tweety Bird thing. A little better. And gives it, makes it pop more. And I can also probably lighten. I don't want to lighten his head too much though, because when I start adding my gradients, which I'm going to do right now. Back and forth here. Darken the feathers a little. Saturation a tad. Actually, kind of a neat idea. Put a little mustache on it. Maintain the white color that's on good suggestion. I like that idea. There's birds that have, like, even a turkey has that thing that kind of goes over it, so that. cute. I'm gonna put the mustache up here. Now, when I start animating this, I'm gonna want the mustache on a separate layer so I can animate it properly. Suggestion on the mustache. Makes the creature a little more interesting. Thank you for hosting us, Miss DJM. I took a nap too. I literally took a nap and went straight to work. So the first bit of my stream, I'm like talking all funny. Oh my. Yeah, that's definitely, that's basically a half sleep, or a half night sleep right there. Raviolio came like right as Miss DJM did. Doing pretty good on Friday. Hey, you guys are so late. I've been doing this for a while already. I already got some creatures drawn. I got this cute little pig bowl. And this is for the grasslands and autumn's lands, so. Yeah, I'm doing this one instead of doing the Grinning Army, because I was kind of going around the map like this, and I just wanted to get to doing this one, that way I just wanted to. And then I was able to, since there's fewer of them, I can color all of them on the stream. This is my favorite one. He's so stupid and cute. Of Exile. I played that for like 10 minutes and I got bored.
Whiskey is awful.
This whiskey.
Ugh.
That cheap Costco stuff. He's a pit bull meets a pig. just like my reference over here. Except he's way cuter in my drawing. They say it's the spiritual successor to Diablo 2, but to me, I actually feel like Dark Souls is more of a spiritual successor to Diablo 2. It's not the same genre of game, but I feel just the art style and the feeling you get just reminds me of Diablo 2 more. I gotta fix the gradient on this guy. I just remembered that. Voila. Better. Now he's more grounded. That's the whole point of why I'm doing these gradients for every drawing. Is they just feel more grounded to have, basically you have like a light source up above, right? So like the sun is casting light down or the clouds are casting light down, and then the ground reflects color, but it's a little easier to do them one by one by just having a darker gradient at the bottom. I seriously love this little dog. Maybe he won't even attack you. Maybe he'll just come up. Oh, that's a good idea. Maybe he'll just heal you. He'll come up and he'll lick you, and then he'll give you health. I really like this little guy. Okay, Okay, I'm gonna make a little note like that. No, he's not a bad guy anymore. I am now making him just a random creature that comes up and heals you by licking you. There. So cute. Put that note over here. I'll keep it by him. Which is totally fine because, supposed to have, we're supposed to have, four pawns, four enemies, and so I have one extra here, so it's fine that this little guy can help you. Yes. I could totally have them just be around the game, and like, you just go up and meet them and they'll just lick you and all your pets and make you all feel better. Another note right here. I'm wondering if maybe he could be one of the things that's around the map. That he's in each of the zones, and if you find him, he'll just stick around with you for the whole map. He just, like, you can set him to follow, and he'll just kind of lick you every now and then and help give you some health for every zone. Kind of neat. Like, you just gotta go find this little pig dog in each zone, and once you find him, he kind of tags along with you. But this dude, I'm really not liking his drawing. If it's like, I don't know, I needed to toy with him. Just looks like shit to me. He just doesn't seem cool. I need to just make his shape more interesting. Well, if you meet him early in the game too, it teaches the player that you may expect him later. So no, he wouldn't be necessary, but the earlier parts of the game aren't really meant to kill the player. I don't like this guy. Actually, just doing this little change gave me a design idea. Maybe he doesn't walk around at all. He's kind of like stationary. But then every now and then he'll just start spinning around the screen. So that's kind of the point of doing these sketches too, is like thinking of game design as you work, because you want to create enemies that are fun to fight and that are unique. You don't want everything to just be like the old Super Nintendo era where they just walk around and smack you if you get close. So maybe it'd be cool if this guy just kind of was like planted, which is why I removed his feet. That would be cute. Or he would just say, woof woof. I'm all for the obscurity. Maybe you could even hear them barking from a distance and you can go find them. Just gotta follow their little barks.
Weef weef,
or
wink wink.
I think weef weef would work better. Wink wink sounds almost like wink wink, but oif sounds different. So maybe this dude, he doesn't walk around like the other ones. Oif. It'd be oif. I just read your message twice, so I basically just answered your question twice. The whiskey is kicking in. That's what's happening. The awful whiskey that I have that I will never buy again. Give this guy kind of a grumpy look. Yeah, that's better. Get rid of his stubby arms. Make him look like a grumpy as hell mushroom. Yes, it is. Look like an army vet, like worms. Oh man, I never told you guys. I'm gonna get a little bit more of this awful whiskey and then continue. It's been going for 2 hours, but I'm like kind of into it, so I'll go for probably another 30-40 minutes. This is why I don't want to have Pig Bull be a bad guy, because puppies are cute. Take the second glass very slowly, otherwise I will not have fun tonight. For me, there's like a certain point to where you enjoy drinking, but then I actually don't like getting drunk at all, so I enjoy just kind of having that fun buzz, and then you can still work and all that. And I know that I can't drink the second glass fast, or I'm not gonna be able to like play games tonight or anything, so have to drink it slow. And I'll probably have to eat something before I actually even finish it. But I'm gonna give this guy some like buff arms. Kind of give him an attitude. That's cool. I like this guy way better now. Here's a random thing. Since the whiskey's giving me a buzz, I'll just talk about random shit while I work. To me, one of the coolest things, if I could ever achieve it in life, is if somehow, someday, I ever just made ass loads of money, and then I was able to buy like a big house, and then I just was able to like have LAN parties all the time. That's like the best kind of life I could ever have. Where I just like have the place, people can come over, I'll buy the food, whatever, I don't care. Like if everyone just comes and we just play games all the time. No. I'd buy better stuff than this, definitely. Give me a good excuse to do something more pink. Maybe he's pissed off that he's pink, that's his problem. Nope. It is not a thing of the past. I just had this discussion with one of my friends at Blizzard. She's still a bit young, but she actually was like, oh, why would you have LAN parties? You're so old. That's like a thing of the past. And then I reminded her, that's because you have LAN parties all the time, because her whole family plays all the time, so they always play stuff together. She has a LAN party with her family all the time. And, so I was like, yeah, if you moved away from your family, you'd start craving that LAN party thing, and there's seriously, like, nothing better than going to a friend's house, and we just did it on Sunday. It wasn't a LAN party, but we went and we played Smash Brothers, and Smash Brothers on Wii U allows up to 8 players, so we had 7 people playing Smash Bros, and it was some of the most fun I have had in years playing a game, to just be there. We had like 12 people, and 7 of the 12 were all playing Smash Brothers, and we just played for hours. It was so fun. I loved it. The trim would be just a little lighter. But I kind of like this, like, what does dichotomy mean? Contrast between two things that are represented being opposed or entirely different. Right. So, I like the dichotomy here of this guy is like a super tough looking guy, and he'll just ruin your day, but he's got really cute pretty colors, so that's a cool dichotomy of like he's super tough but he's really pretty looking. Yeah, Mario Party can do that. I don't like Mario Party though, because I don't actually think it's well designed. It's just, it's luck of dice roll. You can do, the only true skill involved is the mini games. So you can play the mini games as well as you can, but then the rest of the maps that you play, all of them, are dependent on the dice rolls that you have. So If you get bad dice rolls for everything, you could either be much slower than people getting around the map to collect a base star on normal rotation, depending on the map, or you could just be landing on all the red spaces, which makes you lose coins and puts you against people, but again, if you're good with minigames, that's okay. And so you could just be, you could have the worst luck ever, like me, but you could be, like, pretty good at things, but you'd still lose. So, like, you'd get to the end of the game, and all the lucky people would just, that stole all the stars and stole all the coins, and then they have, like, the bonus stars at the end, and you're like, oh, you get the bonus star for winning the most minigames, because it's the only game thing in the whole game that requires skill, and you still lose. So, I don't think Mario Party is a fun game, because it's like Monopoly. Like, there, you don't actually need skill to win Monopoly, you just need to know how the map works, and then you just abuse it every time. So, to me, I consider if we're gonna compete in some couch versus mode or whatever, it doesn't have to be, like, super hard, but there should be a level of skill required to win. Oh man, I love Mario Kart. We were playing that at the little LAN thing we did on Sunday too. And I'd never played the one on Wii, so I sucked. Because the one on Wii, the controls are very different. I actually like characters that drive, like Diddy Kong Racing from 64. And Diddy Kong, when you start power sliding with the R button, it's like you're on ice. So in Diddy Kong, you can actually power slide on straightaways. You just hit the slide and hold the opposite direction, and you can drift an entire map everywhere for the whole lap. And I just like how that feels, because I feel more engaged when I play that way. Like, even on a straightaway, I don't like feeling like, oh, I'm just holding A to go forward. On a straightaway, I like to be doing that icy power slide on a long straightaway, because I have to hold the button, hold the opposite direction, and then control it in the next turn. And that's how Diddy Kong Racing works, and I love that. And Mario Kart kind of does that for the older ones, but in the newer ones, it does not. So for the Mario Kart on Wii U, I lost horrendously. Even when I was choosing carts that had bad handling and bad traction, which is what I like, because I like that slidey, icy feel. And it just didn't work right in Mario Kart, what is that, 9 or 10 now? Drink a beer or two per race? I finish races too fast. So, I'd feel like it's kind of like pit stops, though, it's kind of neat. I feel like I'd race the whole thing, get to that last lap, instead of crossing the line, I would, just, like, chug a beer. Well, I gotta do gradients on this guy. Gradients. drop his skin color down a tad. Tweak the dark. Int. Yeah, Mario Party would actually be a good drinking game, and I think that's the only time I would consider it to be a fun game. As if it was a drinking game. But the most recent time we played it, we were in Santa Monica with my wife's nieces and nephews. And they're like 10 and 12, so they can't play a drinking game. But yeah, I could see Mario Party being a fantastic drinking game. That guy's done. Let's get into this guy. How many do I have to do? This is the last one. Okay, that works, because should wrap this up soon so it doesn't go too long. I like this guy's color scheme in relation to the other ones. Like that, it worked better. Yeah, do you even lift? That's totally what I'm going for, is just like, do you even lift, bro? Kinda, dude, so I'm glad that you picked up on it. Means it's a well-designed character. Yeah, I like this guy way more than how he was at the start. He's got way more attitude. You look at him and you're like, oh man, dude, this guy. Do I even lift? This guy lifts. So this is a little bit more of a color palette from the Mario games, kind of like the red shell, but I think this will work a little better. Kind of fits the palette of the other guys a bit better. Yeah, he's a cannibal, man. They're a race of cannibals. He eats other mushrooms. He eats the Mario mushrooms to get big. Get swole. Actually kinda want him to be a little bigger. Just a little bit. Like that. And you can see when I scale the guy up, he gets kind of shitty and low res, and that's okay because these are mostly just sketches. and I'm getting everything to be correct in relation to one another for their size. Their line detail is not correct. You can see that the line work on this salamander or this lizard dude has much finer line detail than this guy. And that's something I'm not really concerned with right now, because when I start doing true animations, I'm going to be opening up Anaya's run animation, because I'm basing everything off of Anaya. Show what I'm talking about. So her actual PSD file for her her run and her idle is a huge file. It's like 2,000 pixels. Yeah, it's 2048 by 2048. So this is at 100% zoom. So if I were to like take this dude and put it into Anaya's thing, you'd see he was like ridiculously tiny. So he's really small. And that's not how small he's going to be in game, right? So when I do the real animations for him, I'm going to be scaling him up like this for his sprite sheet. And then I'm going to redraw him with the correct line width that I'm using on Anaya. So you can see Anaya's line width is much, much thinner. Very fine line details in comparison to this. When I get to the point of animating all of the creatures, I'm going to be opening up this run sprite sheet, bringing the creatures in, scaling them properly, and then I would basically create a new file and then drop this guy into the new file at this new correct size and completely redraw him, which really actually only takes about 5 minutes, because I'm just gonna trace. I would just trace over him, I drop his opacity down like that, and then I just retrace over him, so then all my line detail when it's in game all matches the relative size of all units. So I'm gonna do that for everything in the game. So yeah, I'm not worried about the line width of things in relation to one another right now. You can see like the knight unit for what I made on Wednesday, his detail is much more fine. This is actually probably more accurate to what he would look like in-game, because Anaya and the pet's lines are very fine. His are very fine. But these guys, some of their lines are too thick. This is way too thick. This guy's a little bit better because he's a rook and huge. He's too thick. But I think that gets my point across, so I'm not going to beat a dead horse. Let's just look at the colors here. Yeah, 2.5 hours. I think that's everything. We have 3 pawns for the grasslands, which would probably be this one and this one. Oh, and then the mushroom. So that'd be 3 pawns for the grasslands, and then we'd have a knight here. Actually, you know what? This mushroom is probably more of a knight. This guy could just be a big pawn that has more health. That makes sense, because this guy's going to be spinning around the map. That's how a knight would act. Very high damage kind of thing. So this guy would be a pawn. He'd just be a tougher pawn. So for the grasslands, the three things you're going to kind of encounter are these guys, as well as you can see I have like blue unit here, and then I probably throw in some of the other pawns from the other areas. You know, that's just how it goes when we work on the project, and we'll tweak things as we go. So we'd have the three pawns plus things from other zones. So we'd have these guys, plus we may have like a goblin guy, a snake, a pumpkin. You know, I have all these things that I can put. Yeah, Pigbull's so cute. Just, his tongue is so big, his eyes are so little. Very cute creature. Is there anything else I want to talk about? I don't think so. I think that covers everything. So, if you guys have any questions, ask me now, or forever hold your peace until Monday. I'm glad Zoltair, I believe it was. This is one of the nice things of, if you want to speak up when I'm working on things, he actually suggested I add this mustache to this bird, and it was a good design choice. Yes, alright, wait. Monday is Memorial Day. Yes, I believe I will stream because I'm not a conventional worker, I work from home. We are going to something for Memorial Day in the evening, but I think we're gonna go, like, right after I stream. I don't have any barbecues that I know of yet. But we're gonna go watch the lanterns lit and let off into the ocean. On Magic Island near Waikiki and Ward. So we're gonna go do that, but that's like right at 6:30. It's almost 6:30 now, so I'd probably just do like a 1.5 hour stream on Monday, and then yes, I'm grateful too. I don't want to ever hurt this little guy. He's just too cute. Alright, well, GG's, kids. Thanks for coming and watching. I'm gonna wrap it up, and I will see you guys Monday, 4 p.m. Hawaii, 7 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. East Coast. And since it's gonna be a shorter one, I might actually go and color these guys, because I want to do some more coloring. That was kind of the nice thing about this. I'm glad you didn't sleep through everything, too. I'll see you guys Monday. We're gonna continue coloring these guys. Alright, thanks for coming and watching. Toodles.